as if they don't know, why, okay, assertiveness, I will tell, okay, you have to come. They are not coming. Then I can use my power to any extent. But I don't know on whose note they are not coming, why they are not coming. When I know that I don't want to concentrate, if solely I told, in spite of all those things, if I'm concentrating on that only protocol issue, no, my intention and to help the people and everything will be tarnished. Only that will be focused. So even when our honorable, when our media friends started asking, okay, everyone is seeing, so no, don't ask about that, because repeatedly when it is done, what should I do? I don't want to use such powers in that way, because they know very well they are on why they are doing this. They are an Indian administrative service. I know very well. I know very well all the protocols, how they should follow, what they should follow, to whom they should follow, everything I know. In spite of knowing they are not coming, I don't want to focus, because I am not at the back of them, behind them, so that you give me respect. I am not expecting. I only tell that this office should be respected. This is not Tamilisai. Tamilisai may sit in this chair or not. Okay, tomorrow another governor come. Well, will you follow the protocol or not? Why you are not following a protocol? Because I am a woman. Otherwise, I am from, I am doing people service. Otherwise, I am not obeying you all in all the ways. Why? Openly come out. I told my office is very transparent. I can give the list of the appointments, how many people I am meeting, what all the parties I am meeting. I am meeting all the parties. It is not only BJP. In fact, I have met BJP people much lesser times than many other parties. So many Congress people I have met, TDP I have met. Even TRS friends, even before they used to come, I have met. All the organizations I have met. Everyone I am meeting. There is no, I am not discriminating. When the appointment list is given, I am not seeing that, oh, this is this party, that party. I know my duty. I am a well-educated person. I am a very social person. I have a very good experience in public life. A governor, how to act as a governor, I know. Out as a political president, I know. The day I stepped in the Raj Bhavan, I started following what a governor should follow, not a political leader. I am holding in charge of another state also. What all my, their lieutenant governor duty is entirely different. Governor duty is entirely different. I am doing my governor duty here and lieutenant governor duty there. But I am disheartened to see the people suffering. So many things can be done. Why it is not done? So if it is not known, how a first citizen can talk? How a governor can talk? When an ordinary citizen can come, how can, why can't a first citizen can talk, cannot talk? That is my question.
నమస్తే మేడం, నేను రెహమాన్ జనం సాక్షి పత్రిక నుంచి. గవర్నర్ పదవి రాజకీయాలకు అతీతమైంది, ప్రజా సమస్యల పరిష్కారానికి విభాగాలు ఉన్నాయి. మీరు అందులో జోక్యం చేసుకోవడం వల్ల మీ పరిధి దాటి వ్యవహరిస్తున్నారని ప్రభుత్వ ప్రతినిధులు అంటున్నారు. మీరు దీని మీద
వెరీ గుడ్ క్వశ్చన్. ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ఇంటర్ఫేరింగ్ ఎట్ ఆల్. I am again telling, I am not a controversial person. I am a constructive person. I am asking one question. Somebody come and tell you. You are not elected representative. Somebody coming and telling you, I am suffering from this problem. You tell, you go and tell your elected representative. If the elected representative is not reachable, if I am reachable, will you write a letter or will you inform your people representatives of your area, this person came and approached me? That is humanitarian. You cannot tell that, oh no, you go and see your elected representative. Your elected representative, if not reachable, if I am reachable, if people believe me and tell me, it is the duty of the elected representative. Even if a common citizen gives a representation, it is the duty of the elected representative to see it. So if the representation is from the governor's office, I won't see, means that's not correct. So if they are performing, why somebody is coming to the Raj Bhavan office? If everything is done, if every people representative is reachable, why they are coming to governor's office? Why the representation is coming to here? It is an easy job for me. But because it is not done, only they are coming. Again and again telling, I am not interfering with the people representative's rights. and I am not in competition with them. As a common citizen, as a person who is concerned about others, this is the only way I am approaching. That's again and again, I said, there is no any personal motive or personal intention, nothing I have. I'm asking before that, why the governor was not allowed to hoist the flag? Why there was not a parade? What made them to pass a resolution in the ministry saying that let the governor hoist the flag inside the Raj Bhavan? It's the pride of the country, it's the pride of the state, it's not the right of the governor. All the states had parade. Why the people of Telangana denied that pride? Did any activities took part in the because of COVID? No political gathering was there. That in COVID was only in Telangana, with all political COVID protocols. All the states, I can say, not even a single state denied the hoisting of the flag. Every state had parade with COVID protocol. That was the second phase, second wave. First wave, it's not the first wave, second wave, which was milder, and all the states, only Telangana is bothered about COVID. Only governor of Telangana should be protected from COVID. All the states had a parade, even central had a parade. If I can accept if there was no any political gathering or no any gathering before the Republic Day, okay. Why can't this keep the seats? The